I think it's perhaps the anti-hero novel. I completed a book called Les Anges de New York, which was published in French, which is about a very, very good guy, a very good cop, a very honest cop, whose personal life is a disaster, a catastrophe. And I thought it would be very interesting to write the opposite. A cop whose professional life appears very competent, very effective, very decent, but behind this he is a crazy guy, an alcoholic, a drug addict, and a criminal. The book begins with him facing his own demons and realizing that he needs to change and he needs to make amends for his life, and yet everything that he does to try and fix things makes them worse. So the book is really about his deterioration. It's like a roller coaster into ever greater catastrophes, but you kind of like him and you want him to succeed and you want him to survive, and you still have to see what happens. I think it's just an example of there's no such thing as a truly good person, and there's no such thing as a truly bad person. I think all of us have facets of good and facets of bad. Everybody is a shade of gray, and I just like to explore the decisions that we make as human beings and how we deal with the consequences of those decisions, even when those decisions are wrong, and how we fight to prove how we are right, even when we are wrong, and how we try and make things good, even when we've created a disaster. So for me, I don't think I write conventional crime novels. I think I write human dramas where the crime is secondary, and we explore the most interesting subject of all, which is the psychology of the human condition. I've just finished a new book, which is for publication in March 2017 in England. It is the first part of a trilogy called Kings of New York, and it begins in the 1920s in America with immigrants, a brother and a sister from Corsica and a young man from Ireland. And it's the story of their involvements, both good and bad, honest and criminal, through 50 or 60 years of the history of Hollywood, through the golden age of noir. And it has cameos and features from famous people and people that we all know and love, like Bogart and F. Scott Fitzgerald and Veronica Lake and these people, James Cagney. It explores our relationship with film, how American film has influenced our society. And it's really an opportunity for me to write about an area of great enthusiasm, which is the great musicals and the great films of the 1930s, 1940s, and 1950s in America.